It's Porter around the wicket and into Wells. Oh, and Wells, has he got something on that down the leg side? Well, Essex are celebrating. Wells is standing. The finger goes up.
Keeper's got his helmet on right behind the stumps. As Jennings looks to carve, has he been caught behind? I think he has. Keep him warm. Bannon drives through the offside. Nice shot through the covers.
Bracewell in again. And well taken, very well taken. Just below shoulder height.
This Snake, see if he can readjust his sights here. He does. And off the back foot, though, it's played very pleasantly by Villas, who forces that one away. In. And again, off the back foot from Villas. This one in front of square, but it's the same result. It's four more runs
this season. Oh, edged. Oh, brilliant catch. Palmer with a sensational one-handed catch. Shuffling in over the wicket and balls. Back of a length, the belly rocks back and swats the ball away through the onside.
Bowls. Loud appeal for LBW and it's given. There was, we're not in a position to judge, but just the confidence of the appeal and the fact that the umpire didn't hesitate for a microsecond to raise his finger suggested that there was little doubt about that, but he did very, very well at... Way! And that's cleaned out the Grandhomme. He seemed to play all rounded and over it.
Here comes Cook in balls. Oh, it's a top edge by Bell. It's flown over the keeper. He'll get four for that, actually. Down towards the fine leg boundary. Hartley back on strike. Cook balls edged through the slips down towards the boundary for four runs. Ball's a short ball, or at least the ball's a back of a length to Bell. He's pulled that beautifully in front of square for four.
Round the wicket. And that's over pitch, played out for four runs through extra cover.
Harmer has the ball back in his hand, is now, and Hartley's gone for it again and pulls Harmer away powerfully over wide mid wicket and for six.
Simon Harmer from the river end of the ground. Again, the reverse sweep attempted by Hartley. It's Harmer asks for LBW and the umpire agrees.
A couple of spots of rain coming back. Short of a length outside the off stump, cracked away to the boundary for four runs, which brings up his 50. And he acknowledges not only the his teammates but the crowd.
Bracewell is in, bowling on Vaughan Bailey. Miscues that one, but will still come through for a sharply taken single. Will he? No, he's run out. Well, Bell set off very, very quickly, and Bailey seemed to be getting there, whether he's just eased off or not, before sliding his bat in, but it's a direct hit from the man at mid-on. As Cook comes in, 188 for 8, the Lancashire score. Into Bell, who edges and is taken at first slip by Sir Alastair Cook, and Bell is out. 60 from 109 deliveries for him, and the end is nigh for Lancashire. They are 188 for 9. Harmer in. Reverse sweep from James Anderson, and he's got all that, and it's gone for four runs, 193 for 9. Cook over the wicket, into the right-handed Williams now, three slips, crouch down, full delivery, hits him on the boot, LBW, Williams is out, Sam Cook has a fifer, and Lancashire are 207 all out here at Chelmsford, which means that tea will be taken, and in around about 20 minutes' time, do rejoin us here, but just to confirm to you, Lancashire, 207 all out, and Sam Cook, 5 for 42. Anderson in once again to Brown, who is out to the third ball of the Essex reply. He's just guided that straight into the hands of slip.
Anderson to Cook. Oh, well, big appeal. Big appeal. Anderson gets Cook.
Yeah, that looked pretty plumb from here. Williams moves in and bowls. Loud appeal for LBW. That meets with the approval of the umpire as well. And Essex are 25 for 3.
Here's Anderson for Lancashire in, and balls driven through the offside by Lawrence. Time that pretty emphatically. Williams to Critchley. It's driven square. Croft will chase after that from cover point. He won't catch up with it. Williams to Lawrence. And there's more runs there. A little back and across and a nice looking back foot drive through the covers for four more. De Grandhomme into the attack for Lancashire. Ball short and wide and carved away for four runs by Dan Lawrence.
In bowls, and a handsome looking shot, and it's just evaded the man at mid off and runs away a little bit down the hill.
Anderson over the wicket and bowls. That's a gorgeous shot by Lawrence, driving through extra cover for four runs.
with Anderson. Bowls to Lawrence, who edges and is caught at second slip. Very good low catch by Keaton Jennings, straight in the bread basket. Just had to adjust the hands very slightly. Exactly the start that Lancashire wanted.
Bailey balls to Critchley. Oh, it's a gorgeous shot. Punched through the offside. Velasquez charging after it again, as does Bohannon. And this time it does get full value.
Here's Anderson again, running towards us. And that's wide, edged and out. And that was well wide. And it's a catch by Luke Wells, his second of the innings.
Balls, and that's edged and taken by Wells. And Harmer goes for naught.
White wristbands on the left and right wrists, in and bowling. And Critchley just waits for that one and angles it away just behind square on the offside. Here's Anderson in and bowling. That's whipped away down to long leg for four runs. As Williams is in now, well wide of off stump, and that's driven away by Critchley in front of square, and that will race away for four runs.
De Grondhout moves in now from the river end, the end from which we're commentating, and that's just played down backwards of square on the offside, and that is Matt Critchley's third consecutive half century this season. He's only had three innings and three half centuries.
Again, to Doug Bracewell, and Bracewell edges, and this time is caught.
In to start another over. Critchley comes down the pitch. He's edged it through the gap between second slip and gully down towards third man for four. De Grondhout over the wicket to Snater. Has he edged it behind to Bell? He has, yeah. He's gone for six.
Come back to that. And that's down, played down to third man for another boundary. And that's out. Worked straight into the hands of Bailey at mid-wicket. And Cook is out for a very diligent, a very useful 20 runs.
Williams to Critchley, he's down the pitch, he's gone high through the offside and he's caught out at deep extra cover by Colin de Grondhout. And Critchley's gone for 78. That's the end of the Essex first innings. Here's Cook to Jennings, that's worked off the pads to the left of mid-wicket and down towards the square leg boundary. Lovely timing, actually.
Here's Porter in and bowling to Wells. Big shout for LBW here, and given! Luke Wells has to go, and someone's going to need to tell him, you have to go.
Porter to Jennings. He runs here for the Lancashire captain. Little flick away off the hip. Oh, he's timed that beautifully for four, actually. At least one more over before tee. Flick this one away again through the onside. This, I think, got a little in front of square. It's a lovely shot for four runs. He's over the wicket to Bohannon. Oh, that's played down through that third man region. It's uppishly.
And that's worked away backwards of square on the offside. And that is going to cross the boundary. Next delivery is played handsomely through the covers for four. That's arguably the shot of the day, I thought, for my money. It was very, very well executed. Right up over the wicket to Jennings, who advances on him and then carves it away through the offside for four more. As it's Cook taking over the bowling from the far end, the Hayes close end.
Porter bowled him! Stunning delivery from Porter, cuts back in, and that's the first wicket of the day.
It's Cook to Croft. Edged, caught at third slip by Dan Lawrence, and Sam Cook gets a wicket that, in truth, he really does deserve for the way he's bowled in the second innings.
Comes in now, right on over, up to Sumps. Bowls full, driven back past the ball. That's a nice shot. Great shot to get off the mark. Four straight down the ground by Vias. Porter up to the stumps again as batsman just moves outside off and flicks the way through the leg side. That's a lovely shot. It's going to run away for four runs as well. Backward a square on the leg side. Bracewell bowls. That one's flicked off the pads down towards deep square leg for a single. And that brings up the 50 for Jennings. And the 101 up for Lancashire.
And that's all pulled in the air. It's going to be caught by Porter at Milan. And the fourth wicket is about to fall. It's a complete miscue, which leaves Lancashire on 111 for four.
That's a lovely shot clipped by Bell through mid-wicket. He's timed that for four runs. And Snater bowls. And that takes an edge. It's all on the ground, though. It beats the dive of Harmer at second slip. Porter to Bell. That's a lovely shot. Eased it away through mid-wicket. Couldn't have come back for two. Will it reach the rope?
Yep.
Oh, it does. The beautiful timing from Bell.
Tossed up by Harmer. Driven through the offside. That should be four runs. Square of the wicket. And it goes over the boundary rope for four. 157 for four. And he's in now and he bowls. That's cut away through the offside. Yep, short, wide. And it was there to be slapped away.
Back into to Jennings. Drives through mid-on. And beats the dive of mid-on and down towards the boundary.
It's a lovely stroke. It's actually a full toss, but it's still a very, very well timed away through mid-wicket for four.
Jennings waits, carves this ball away from Porter, bouncing down towards a deep backward point boundary. Snater to Bell. That's a beautiful shot. Oh, he enjoyed that. Look at the walk from Bell. Down the pitch with the follow-through. Beautiful from Bell. It brings up a 50 as well. Lovely way to get there. Gorgeous straight drive from Bell.
As Harmer bowls, as an LBW appears straight and he's gone. Yeah, it looked good from up here. Bell launched forward trying to defend it, but it just straightened off the seam. And online as well. Big shot coming down the pitch here and he's out. Jennings is out on 96. He came down for a big shot. It skewed off the inside of the bat all the way down the throat of Tom Wesley. And backward points. A big shot coming in on the leg side. Now that's up in the air, but I think it's going to clear the boundary quite easy. It has. It's gone off the... I think that's come off the balcony.
Here is Harmer.
Oh, Harmer. And that's a big sweep over deep mid-wicket. That's a huge hit by de Granholm. That's gone out of the ground and probably into the river behind us. Right arm round to de Granholm. Big swipe. That one goes up in the air, but he's got the length on it as well. That's gone for six.
And Snater bowls. And here, Hartley gets one he can hit. He does so very well. It's overpitched on off stump, and he's hit it away just in front of square cover quickly for four.
Down the wicket comes Hartley, driven through the offside. Lovely shot. That's going to go for four runs.
Oh, it's bowled him. Oh. That's the end of de Granholm. One swipe too many. And, well, Bracewell's broken through.
His Harmer brings Bailey down the pitch and Bailey lofts the ball out towards deep mid-wicket. And he's gone for six.
Three of us at the edge of the fielding circle. What would be the fielding circle if there was one? And that's a lovely hit. Clumped away over deep cover for six by Hartley. He's picked up Bracewell on length there. As this is driven away down the ground. Good hit. That's a fine stroke by Hartley. And I think it's cleared the boundary at long off.
Into Bailey. That's clubbed away high over the pavilion in that direction. Out towards deep mid-wicket. He's gone for six.
No cook this morning, and that's driven away down the ground, and again it's hit straight and it's hit true, and it's another six, and it's going to be 50 for Hartley. And he raises the bat to the Lancashire dressing room. What a fine effort this has been. Well, they'll consider that. This is hit uppishly but safe and a long way. Fine shot. That's six over deep mid wicket as Porter bowls to him, and it bowls as a block hole delivery, and it's just glided down to fine leg for one. They'll consider a second, but it's not going to be there. That's the end of the over. A little bit less damaging than the previous one from Porter's point of view. It just went for 10, but at 351 for 7 surely declared, it means that Essex will need to get 340 to win this game.
Anderson in round the wicket to the left hand. Oh, that's low. That's hit him straight in front and he's out. Yep, that looked pretty adjacent. It kept low, got through Cook's defences, and Essex lose their first wicket. Anderson takes the wicket of one of his best mates, and Cook goes.
The value of a draw can be... that's an LBW. That is LBW. It kept very low. Very low indeed, and Brown had no chance. It was a delivery from Bailey that was right on line, and must have hit him round about boot height.
It to ground on to Lawrence. That's punched through wide mid off. Anderson will chase after it, but he might as well give up.
60 odd, 8 odd overs that have been required. Here's a nice drive down the ground. That's going to be going all the way to the mid-on boundary, notably from Hartley. This is driven nicely. I tell you what, Critchley's looking in fantastic form. Bailey is over-pitching there, and that's put away for four.
Mid-wicket, a short leg and a leg slip. That's pulled away in the air, imperiously out to the boundary. A couple of bounces and four runs. And he's in now, bowls down the leg side. I think that's come off the pads. Let's have a look, see what the umpire says. Nope, it's runs, flicked away by Wesley. The ground up. Oh, that keeps low. That should be LBW. Yes, it's given. That one kept low as well. Bowls, and that's driven nicely through the offside. Don't think that's going to get to the boundary. There's two fielders in chase. In fact, it might, actually. And that rolls over the rope. It does.
Hartley again to bowl with five men around the bat. Just, again, another defensive shot played back down the pitch. The end of the over. Surely this is going to be a draw now. There just isn't the feel of the momentum that Lancashire need.